It's the art of dentistry. Dr. Robin Rutherford.
Welcome back. Last week in the Art of Dentistry, we talked about gum disease and how you can treat it. Today, Dr. Robin Rutherford is here to talk about the different tools dentists use when you have gum disease. Dr. Rutherford, thank you so much for being here today.
I enjoy it.
Okay, so first, let's quickly review what you discussed last week.
Okay, last week I said two big misconceptions that people have and one big lie that is out there. Mm-hmm. One misconception is that any amount of bleeding is okay. When you bleed, when you brush your teeth and you bleed just a little bit, isn't that normal? No, mm-hmm. It's not. If your gums ever bleed when you brush your teeth, you need to go to the dentist because that's not good. The second misconception was that you can just brush your teeth harder and get off the tartar and you don't need to go to the dentist mm-hmm. and have your teeth cleaned. No, once it has hardened on, it's only the dentist and the hygienist that can clean your teeth for you.
Okay.
And the big lie was all about mouthwash. Mm-hmm. Lavoris and Listerine and products like that are completely worthless. If you have bad breath, it is because you have an infection in your mouth. And that means you have gum disease. And no amount of rinsing with something that will give you minty fresh breath for about 2 minutes mm-hmm. will cover that. No, you just have a problem and we need to fix it.
Okay, so what does the dentist do? They think you have gum disease.
Okay, if a person comes into me and we want to check your gums thoroughly, mm-hmm. and the first thing that we do, of course, I'm going to look in your mouth, you know, and just visually look at things. But the second thing is we need to make some little measurements around the edges of each and every tooth. Mm-hmm. And this first photo shows a little instrument. It's just a plastic measuring stick. It's on the left there. I just put up a big pin next to it just to show you that it's about that size.
Right.
And in the second photo kind of zooms in on that. But this is just a little measuring stick marked off in distances.
Okay.
And we just measure around the edges, and that's one way that you tell kind of what the topography, the ups and the downs around the teeth and around the gums are. If you go to a dentist and they just eyeball your teeth and just look but don't measure, mm-hmm. and they say, yes, you do have gum disease, or no, you don't have gum disease, that's really not any way you can do it. You have mm-hmm. to measure. And so that would be somebody that is not, I don't know, maybe as knowledgeable about gum disease as you would like.
Okay.
But that's something that we have to do, is to make our little measurements.
Yeah, so that's an important step that your dentist needs to do.
Yeah.
Okay.
And cleaning your teeth, the reason it's important is the whole reason your gums are infected is because of the tartar, also known mm-hmm. as calculus, that is on your teeth. And that will not brush off. Once it has hardened on, it takes the hygienist to professionally clean your teeth. And it's kind of like saying you have a splinter in your finger. If you have a splinter in your finger, you can take antibiotics until the cows come home. Not gonna fix it, is it? You could rinse it with a mouthwash. Not gonna fix anything, is it?
Right.
No, you have to get the splinter out because that's the source of the problem.
Okay.
Then it will heal. Well, once we clean your teeth and get all of that stuff off and out from under the edges of the gums, then your gums can begin to heal and not be infected anymore.
Okay, so depending on how severe your gum disease is, it's gonna take several visits to come.
It might.
Okay.
Yeah, a preventive cleaning every 6 months or so mm-hmm. is when you don't have gum disease yet and you don't want it mm-hmm. and you want to keep your teeth clean so it doesn't get started. Now, if you have gum disease, then it may take more effort than that. And so we may need to see you 3 or 4 times in a row, once a week or something like that, and you keeping things clean every day yourself at home, but plus what we do to get you past this infection and to get everything back healthy again. And then maybe it gets back to just having your teeth cleaned routinely every once in a while.
Okay.
One of the instruments that we have nowadays, in addition to just cleaning your mm-hmm. teeth, which has been the basis always and still is, but now here's another photo next to my little famous Bic pen to show you how big this little handheld laser is.
Okay.
And my hygienists use a laser, and it's a, you might say a cold laser or something like that, so it's comfortable, but it just gives a little warm feeling, but it stimulates the healing around the edges of the gums.
Mm-hmm.
And that's something that 10 years ago we didn't have.
Wow.
So who knows what we'll be doing 10 or 20 years from now.
Yeah.
But nowadays we have tools that we didn't used to have that can help you not lose your teeth from gum disease. So if you think you have gum disease, if your gums ever bleed, if your breath is not good, mm-hmm. if your spouse is telling you these things, you know, give us a call.
Okay.
Because we can definitely help you.
All right, well, Dr. Rutherford, thank you so much for being with us today.
Always enjoy it.
It's the art of dentistry.